This week in Nerf, we've got airsoft companies making Nerf blasters, more 2018 Nerf blasters spoiled, and a blaster with two magazine wells. I'm Jangular, and this is your source for first-party, third-party, and community Nerf news every Saturday morning. Jumping right on in, like I mentioned, airsoft companies making Nerf blasters. Well, Nerf-compatible blasters, I'd say, is a better way to put it, but Elite Force, or Umarex, has announced or showcased their Wrecked line at the SHOT Show this year, and it was in a video from US Airsoft that I'll link down below. Here's a screen grab from it, and they are M4 shells. They look like M4s. They've got vertical pump grips, and they're going to be retailing for under $100 is pretty much all we know at the moment, and they're going to average around 90 FPS. Now, that's not huge for those of us in the community that averagely, you know, play games with an average of 130, 150, or 200 or whatnot, but if there is room for modification of these blasters, then maybe it's a better shell to start with. Maybe it's, or rather, better internals to start with. Maybe they're more reinforced. I don't know. This is all speculation at this point in terms of what they'll be on the inside. They are M4 shells, though. It is important to note. So if you're playing in a public game, I probably wouldn't bring one of these out to it. With everything going on, I probably wouldn't use one of these in public, which is unfortunate. I did reach out to the company to see if I could get some more information. I was told to contact this one person. I did. Have not heard back yet, unfortunately. Waiting to do so. Hopefully, if I get back some more information, I'll share it with all of you. Just general details on how the internals work, what their plans are for the future, if more is coming. Hopefully, if this does well, we will see more offerings from them or other airsoft companies that have experience in kind of flinging projectiles at people for fun, for sport and whatnot, that we'll see some more, I don't want to say innovations, but more offerings in the scene that we can work with. Maybe they'll do some more things that maybe don't look so realistic, but have a different kind of take on the aesthetic, stuff that can be used in public. But I would love to see some more kind of crossover between the two hobbies. I think they'd be great. I don't really like the vitriol that goes, you know, from back and forth and between all the different hobbies like airsoft and paintball and Nerf and whatnot. So I would love to see more crossover, and I think this could be a good step if they do things right in the right direction. But like I said, hopefully I'll have some more information on that in the future for you if I hear back from them, and I will let you know. Next up, Geek.com posted up their article with two more new blasters, both of which are essentially potentially new sublines within lines that we already have. The first up is the Zombie Strike Survival System Scavenger. And this is going to retail for $50. It is it's an updated Slingfire. There's no real way to get around it. It has a similar prime, a similar look, kind of in the way it all works, but the big difference on this one is that it is slam fire capable, which is a nice touch. It's a neat touch. It also has a bunch of rails and attachment and an attachment point on the back for a stock and one on the front for a barrel attachment. So there's a whole bunch of stuff going into this, and it feels to me like the survival system is essentially the Zombie Strike version of the Modulus system, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. It's going to ramp up the prices for these products, which you may not be happy about, but we are still going to have more accessory options, which is great for the kids. It's great for the target demographic for these things. And rail space and attachment points for us in the hobby are great for being able to just work with extra things and put extra things on, and just, it gives us options, which, you know, I'm a fan of. So that is something I'm pretty happy with. Now, it is cool that on the stock of this, we do get a jolt. It holds one. And I do like that we have a Nerf branded mag holder for a rail adapter. How sturdy it will be, we'll find out. But I do like that they are branching out and adding more things like that. I think it's a nice touch, and it's a good step. So I'm curious to see how this kind of evolves as another subline. And from one subline to another, the next up from the Geek.com article is the Modulus Ghost Ops Evader. This is the Ghost Ops line beginning. I'm assuming this is a $40 retail blaster. It is a clear semi-auto flywheeler. I like clear shells. They're really cool. They're pretty awesome. So I'm fairly happy about this. It does use a side magwell. So for those of you that like the Raid or the Rampage, anything that uses a side-loading magwell, this is an option for you. This is something new and something different that they're adding in for the flywheels. Now, of course, it's a flywheel blaster, so you can throw your litany of it's a strife reshell, yada yada. That doesn't bother me. I personally don't understand all of the hate towards different aesthetics for something that functions similar. I like seeing options. I like seeing different things in the field. I like not everyone running the exact same blaster because it's the only thing that functions a certain way. Way back when the Elite line started and games were being taken over by the Elite Alpha Trooper and the Strife and then the Rapid Strike, or sorry, the Strife first, then the Elite Alpha Trooper, then the Rapid Strike, that was all we saw. That was everything. And so as we got more and more options and more variety, it just really opens things up in terms of what blaster shells people are running. And I think that's a good thing. So personally, I don't like to trash these kinds of different takes on how a certain system works. So that's my, inject a little bit of my opinion in here while we get some facts out there. But it does come with a barrel extension and it all lights up. There's an extra trigger or a button that lights things up. And I think it's a neat gimmick, a neat kind of aesthetic. It's cool. People have been putting LEDs in blasters for a while now, so why not? Hasbro figures, why don't we do it? We'll do the work for you for those that don't want to. And yeah, you know what? Kudos to you. And for $40, I honestly would have thought they would have charged more for this. So that's a good thing. It's not cheap. It's not like original Strife cheap, but hey, it's not $60 because it has lights in it. So small victories. That said, I'm not a huge fan of the shell itself for myself, but I'm sure there are gonna be people that are gonna love this. And hopefully the thing that I'm most excited about is that this Ghost Ops line will bring back more clear shell blasters, because I don't know, something about clear shells and tinted shells, they just look so nice. They really do. So that's kind of my take on the Evader. And let's move on to the next blaster that is not from Hasbro. This was a post from Dertes Michel. We talked about this a little bit last week, and we're following up on it this week because he posted more information about it. And this is the Busby Mutator. This was from the Toy Fair Germany, and it is a bolt action blaster similar to the Master Tack or the Snipe. And it has a removable stock, which is nice, but the real big thing that everyone's talking about is the dual magazine wells. And they're right next to each other, and we speculated a little bit last week about how it functions, what they do, is one non-functional, just storage. They appear to both be functional, and there's two different modes in this blaster. Whether or not they're actually different performance points, we don't know. We'll find out when we get our hands on it. But when you pull out or push in the barrel, it changes which magazine is active, so they should switch up and down depending on which one you're using. And I assume because you're pulling out the barrel, the breech is moving with it, and that's, you know, being pushed in or pushing the darts in, or essentially it's moving all the parts and components so the magwell should function properly, I would hope. What that means for modifying, I don't know. It'll be interesting. Regardless, I think this is a really cool idea, and I'm really curious to see what people do with it in the future. And the shell really isn't bad. So there's some really cool things that I think people could do, or hopefully will do, with this system that I'm really looking forward to. But that's gonna do it for all the new blaster news, but that's not all the blasters we have to talk about this week. Let's move to the mod of the week. And that comes to us from Decepticreeper Customs. And this is Death's Head 2. This is a comic book inspired build off of the character Death's Head 2. And I really like the way the carry handle looks in this Strife. I never really thought much about putting it on there, but it kind of works. I kind of dig the way it looks. I don't know. I mean, the carry handle, the Modulus, it was neat, but putting it on the Strife, it just, something about it really struck me and really, really, I enjoyed it. I really thought it was cool looking, and I dig the colors they went with. I dig the scheme and the layout, and just kind of the overall effect and look of it works for me. On the inside, he's got some of the details. I will link to the post down below. Go check that out. Also linked is their Instagram. So if you want to check out more of their work, definitely go check that out, because it's a cool build. I like it. I like seeing comic book inspired stuff. It speaks to me. You know, I always enjoy creative, interesting things, and this fell into that for me. Now, the video of the week, this comes to us from QH Ventures. This is Quick Flag number 3. You know I love competitive Nerf. Anything competitive, I like to share with all of you. And this is a short highlight video of the most recent Quick Flag event, which is in a new venue that is absolutely awesome. They have an indoor venue, and they actually have like bleachers above or overhang above where they can look down and watch the games. And that's so cool to me. It's an awesome location. It's awesome footage. QH Ventures is a really, really talented photographer and videographer. So his style is really, really nice, and I really enjoy it. So I definitely recommend, if you got like a minute and a half to go kill, watch that video. It is an awesome video, well worth your time, and it gets me wanting to get out and Nerf. So that video is gonna be right over here. If you wanna watch that, feel free to click it. If you enjoyed this video, let me know in the comments what you thought of all the new blasters. Airsoft Company's getting into it, the new Hasbro blasters, the Busbee blaster, the Mutator, the mod of the week, the video of the week. Let me know all of it in the comments below. If you're new to the channel and enjoyed this video, every single Saturday we do Nerf News, 7 a.m. PST in the morning, and we got gameplay videos, reviews, and other fun stuff on the channel as well. So hit that subscribe button for more in the future. And as always, thank you so much for watching. I'm Jangular, and I'll see you next time.